بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حمدا ومصليا وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In today's lesson on علم المعاني, we're going to begin chapter 3 of the science, which discusses the predicate of a sentence. And today we're going to learn why you'd omit or mention the predicate. The reasons for omitting the predicate are actually the same as the reasons for omitting the subject, which we learned near the beginning of the previous chapter. Let's go through some examples to refresh our memory. Our first example is by a poet, Dhabi ibn al-Harith, who says, وَمَنْ يَكُ أَمْسَى بِالْمَدِينَةِ رَحْلُهُ فَإِنِّي وَقَيَّارٌ بِهَا لَغَرِيبُ. Whosever destination lands him in the city by eventide, but indeed Qayyar and I are strangers in the city. Basically, the poet's expressing sorrow over being a stranger in the city where everyone seems to be at home. Now, notice the grammatical structure in the second couplet. We have inna, the ism of inna, which is the ya, and the khabar of inna, which is biha la gharibu. So here we have a full sentence with a mentioned subject and a mentioned predicate. But then what happens to the word qayyar? The astute among you will notice that because of some grammatical technicalities, we can't exactly incorporate qayyar into the ism of inna. So we can't say ya with qayyar becomes the ism of inna and la gharibu biha becomes the khabar. We can't do that. So it has to be made a separate sentence on its own. Basically, we have two sentences at the end of the day. I am a stranger to it, to the city, and Qayyar is a stranger to the city. Two separate sentences like that. But in the second sentence, all that's been mentioned is the text of the poem, and in the text of the poem is Qayyar, and the predicate has been omitted. Why? Why didn't the poet just say, I am a stranger to it, and Qayyar is a stranger to it? Both sentences, full, you know, fully mentioned. There are many reasons. Firstly, the meaning is understood based on what has been mentioned. So repetition of the predicate would be superfluous. Secondly, a poet doesn't have much room in a single couplet to mention every little word. Thirdly, even if the poet did have room, he needs to preserve the meter and the rhythm. And fourthly, poetry is obviously, you know, often concise in words and expansive in meaning. And this is just, you know, yet another example of that. So in this one example, we've seen four of the reasons for omitting the predicate of a sentence. And if you refer to the lesson on omitting the subject of a sentence from the previous chapter, you'll notice the same reasons appearing there as well. One thing to always remember, though, as we learned in the previous chapter, is that you can only omit the subject or predicate if you leave a clue that something has been omitted. Obviously, you can't just omit something and have the meaning change or, you know, leave the reader confused. That goes without saying. Another example of omitting the predicate comes in the form of fa fujaiya, which holds the meaning of suddenly. For instance, kharajtu fa idha zaidun. I left the room and suddenly there was Zaid. So notice that only the subject Zaid has been mentioned. The predicate, something like mawjudun, has been omitted. The reason for this is that is idiomatic usage. Typically with fa fujaiya, the sentence that it enters upon will have its predicate omitted. You know, because it's understood that it's going to be something like suddenly he was there, or suddenly there he stood, or something along those lines. So there's no need to mention it in this type of structure. Our next example comes from a poet who says, إِنَّ مَحَلًا وَإِنَّ مُرْتَحَلًا وَإِنَّ فِي السَّفَرِ إِذْ مَضَوْ مَهَلًا. Verily we have in this world an arrival, and towards the next we have a journey. And indeed among the travelers, when they pass, there is a distance. The poet is basically saying that in this world, we have a short stop, and towards the next world, we have our journey, one that many before us have embarked upon, and of course, there's no returning back for them, and we are soon to follow in their footsteps. That's the gist of the poem. Now, notice the sentence in inna mahallan, and you'll notice the same thing in inna murtahala. Here, the predicate has been omitted. The full sentence would have been inna lana fid dunya mahallan. Many of the reasons for omitting the predicate here are the same as we've already seen. The poet has to mind the available space, he has to preserve the meter, and so on. But there's an additional reason in this couplet. The poet is trying to leave it up to the reader to figure out exactly what he's saying, instead of just spelling it out. By saying something like, verily a journey, you know, and just leaving it at that, this really pushes the reader to think about what's being communicated. It grabs the reader's attention, it forces a thought process, it gives the reader greater joy when he figures something out himself. It respects the reader by assuming he is capable of figuring things out. Omitting the subject or predicate of a sentence to achieve this is called al-udulu ila aqwa dalilain. Let's do another example. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Yusuf, quoting Yaqub alayhi salam, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, thus a great patience. Notice that this is not a full sentence. But the interesting thing here is that we can either assume that this is the subject and the predicate has been omitted, or that this is the predicate and the subject has been omitted. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ أَجْمَلٌ, a great patience is better. Or فَأَمْرِي صَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, my course of action will be a great patience. Part of the purpose of omission here is to allow for both interpretations. If there was no omission, one of these interpretations would have to be determined, it would have to be fixed. The verse would lose flexibility in that case. It's pretty neat. Now, as for mentioning the predicate of a sentence, the primary reason is that mentioning is default. And, you know, as long as there's nothing causing us to opt away from the default, we'll mention the predicate. But there are some reasons beyond this that particularly encourage us to mention the predicate. It may be default to mention it, but there are some particular, you know, reasons that we're especially going to mention it. And we've seen a lot of those from the previous chapter on mentioning the subject. One of those reasons is to avoid confusing or messing up the meaning of the sentence. Another reason is to be condescending to the listener and spell everything out for him.